From the first landing of Christopher Columbus in 1492 to the fall of the Aztec and Inca empires, the conquistadors of the Spanish Empire were a force to be reckoned with. Driven by a competitive and fierce desire for gold, glory, power, and the spread of Christianity, the conquistadors rapidly expanded the Spanish Empire and laid the foundations for the existence of Latin America. However, their actions also had devastating consequences for the indigenous peoples of the Americas, giving way to widespread European colonization. Hernán Cortés is a name that echoes to the annals of history, a Spanish conquistador who shaped the course of world events through his voyages and exploration. He was born in Medellin, Spain, in 1485, drawn to adventure and exploration. In 1519, Cortés embarked on his famous expedition with 600 men to conquer the Mexican interior. The Aztec Empire was the dominant power in the region, ruled by Emperor Moctezuma II. Cortés quickly formed alliances with neighboring states that harbored hatred towards the empire. As he ventured deeper into Mexico, he added thousands of Mesoamerican warriors to his ranks. In March, they reached the Aztec capital of Tenochtitlan, and Moctezuma welcomed Cortés graciously. However, Cortés was not content with just being a guest in Tenochtitlan. He craved the riches of the Aztecs, and imprisoned Moctezuma in his palace. When he heard that he was to be imprisoned, he took off, but not before overseeing Moctezuma's death, either by the stones of rioting Aztecs, or perhaps even by the hands of the Spanish themselves. Upon his return a few months later, he defeated the Spanish troops sent to arrest him and took Tenochtitlan for himself in August 1521. He razed the city and established Mexico City in its place, becoming the governor of New Spain. However, his time as governor was short-lived as he was removed from his position by Spanish Emperor Charles V. Cortés embarked on a new expedition in 1536, exploring the Pacific coast and discovering the Baja Californian Peninsula. After achieving all this, Cortés retired to Spain 5 years later, seeking recognition for his achievements in Mesoamerica, but to no avail. He died in 1547. Hernán Cortés' legacy is one of great accomplishments, but his greed for wealth and power, and his ruthless treatment of the indigenous population overshadows his achievements. His expeditions resulted in the introduction of European diseases in Mexico, but also opened the way for further exploration and conquest of the Americas. Pizarro was born in Trujillo, Spain in 1472. He grew up poor, with little education, but was known for his quick wits and ambition. He traveled to the New World in 1509, participating in several expeditions and conquests probing South America for a famed Golden Empire. But it was his expedition to Peru that would make him a legend. In 1530, Pizarro set sail from Panama to Peru with 200 men. They raided and pillaged coastal villages along the way, marching inland in 1532. They'd meet the Incas in November, requesting to meet with their emperor. Pizarro's arrival to the Inca Empire was well-timed. The European diseases, brought about by those like Cortés, had reached South America, killing off most of the population. The previous Incan Empire had succumbed to these diseases in 1528, leaving his two sons, Huáscar and Atahualpa, the heads of opposing sides of a bloody civil war. Atahualpa would be the victor, however, and would be the one to meet Pizarro. Upon meeting him, Atahualpa refused to convert to Christianity, and war broke out. Pizarro's men defeated the Incas, their gunpowder proving superior. Atahualpa was captured, and despite giving Pizarro his treasury for his ransom, was executed in 1533. Over the years, Pizarro faced opposition from other Spanish conquistadors who were vying for power in the region, He also had to contend with rebellions from the Incan people, who were angry and resentful of Spanish rule. In the end, it was a group of disgruntled Spanish conquistadors who brought down Pizarro. In 1541, Pizarro was assassinated in his palace in Lima by a group of men led by his lieutenant, Diego de Almagro. Pizarro's legacy, however, lived on. He had opened South America to Spanish colonization and laid the foundations for the creation of modern-day Peru. Born in 1474, Juan Ponce de León joined Columbus on his second voyage to the New World as a young man, eager to see what treasures lay beyond the horizon. He quickly made a name for himself by helping the Spanish enslave the indigenous Taino people, and was rewarded for his efforts with the governorship of the eastern part of Hispaniola. However, it was Ponce de León's subsequent journeys to Puerto Rico and Florida that truly cemented his place in history. In 1508, he was granted permission by the Spanish crown to explore and colonize Puerto Rico. Ponce de León established the settlement of Cabeza and began to explore the island in search of gold and other riches. The quest for the mythical Fountain of Youth led de León to explore north. According to legend, the Fountain of Youth was a magical spring whose waters had the power to restore youth and vitality to anyone who drank from it. Ponce de León set out to find this fabled fountain, hoping to unlock its secrets and gain eternal youth. He believed that the Fountain of Youth lay somewhere on the island of Bimini, which he thought was located somewhere to the north of Cuba. In 1513, he set sail and landed on the eastern coast of Florida, which he named La Florida, in honor of the vibrant landscape he encountered. Although he never found the Fountain of Youth or the island of Bimini, his explorations of Florida helped establish Spanish claims to the region. Vasco Núñez de Balboa is remembered as a significant figure in Spanish history, leaving behind a legacy of his cruel and ruthless personality, as well as his controversial conquest of Panama. Balboa arrived in Panama in 1510 and quickly established himself as a powerful figure in the region, and used this power to launch an expedition across Panama in search of gold. During this expedition, Balboa enslaved the local First Nations, forcing them to work for him and his men. He established the city of Darien as a base for his operations and used it as a launch pad for further exploration and conquest. He made alliances with local tribes, but when he saw that they did not possess the amount of gold that he wanted, he turned to violence and cruelty. Balboa imposed a heavy tribute on the indigenous people, forcing them to give him gold and slaves. During his expedition, Balboa stumbled upon the Pacific Ocean and claimed it for Spain. He became the first European to see the ocean and named it the Southern Sea. His cruel treatment of the local people led to resistance, and some of the indigenous tribes rebelled against him. Despite his achievements, Balboa's actions eventually led to his downfall. The governor of Panama, Pedro Arias de Villa, saw Balboa as a threat and accused him of treason. Balboa was arrested and found guilty, executed by beheading in 1519. Álvar Núñez Cabeza de Vaca was a Spanish conquistador who had a unique experience during his travels through North America. In 1527, he was part of an expedition led by Pamphila de Narvaez to conquer Florida. However, Narvaez's ships were hit by a storm off the coast of Florida, and many of the crew members, including Narvaez himself, were lost at sea. Cabeza de Vaca and a small group of survivors managed to make it to the shore, but their situation was dire. They soon realized that their only chance of survival was to seek help from the local First Nations. They had been enslaved by the indigenous of Galveston Island, acting as medicine men in return for food. Despite these initial challenges, Cabeza de Vaca was determined to survive. By 1530, Cabeza de Vaca ran errands for the indigenous of the Texan mainland, budding relationships with and between the First Nations. As he traveled inland towards the west, he became an expert in trading and bartering, serving as a healer and mediator. Cabeza de Vaca's experiences with the Native Americans had a profound impact on him. He began to see the world in a different way, and he developed a new appreciation for their cultures and beliefs. His prestige as a miraculous medicine and holy man led to many indigenous following him, his group's journey to the Pacific coast, calling themselves Children of the Sun. After 8 years of wandering, Cabeza de Vaca reached the Pacific coast in 1536. Upon his return to Spain, he published his experiences in a book called The Story of Álvar Núñez Cabeza de Vaca, an important historical document that sheds light on the early encounters and the way of life between the Spanish and the First Nations. Hernando de Soto was a Spanish conquistador who played a significant role in the conquest of Nicaragua and opening the North American interior to further exploration. Though his parents wished for him to take a priesthood or become a lawyer, de Soto joined an expedition to the New World in 1514. He arrived in Nicaragua in 1524 and quickly became the region's chief slave trader. After his conquest of Nicaragua, de Soto joins Francisco Pizarro in a quest to conquer the Inca Empire in the 1530s, playing a crucial role in the defeat of the Incas and the capture of Atahualpa, and was the first European to enter Cuzco, the Inca capital, in 1533. Given permission by Charles V, de Soto explored the southern United States in search of gold. He landed in Tampa Bay, Florida in 1539 with 600 men and an abundance of equipment and food. Along the way, the Spanish enslaved and killed the indigenous peoples as they traveled northward, spreading European diseases among the indigenous they came across. De Soto reached as north as modern-day North Carolina, noting excellent agricultural lands, fine pottery, and impressive burial mounds. They crossed the Appalachian Mountains and down the Mississippi River, crossing into Arkansas. Still without their gold, De Soto and his men crossed the river again, and De Soto soon fell ill, dying of what was likely fever in 1542. The rest of his men soon returned to New Spain. Francisco Vázquez de Coronado was a Spanish conquistador best known for his search for the fabled Seven Cities of Gold in the southwestern United States. In 1540, he set out for Mexico City with an army of Spanish soldiers and indigenous slaves to explore the region. Coronado's expedition was arduous. The desert landscape was inhospitable, and his men suffered from hunger, thirst, and disease. Despite these difficulties, Coronado pressed on, driven by the promise of riches and glory. As he traveled through what is now Arizona, New Mexico, and Texas, Coronado encountered numerous First Nations, including the Pueblo Yelling Zuni people. He and his soldiers often clashed with them, leading to violence and bloodshed. Despite their efforts, Coronado and his men never found the fabled cities of gold. Still following whispers of these cities, Coronado and his men journeyed north from the Rio Grande River into present-day Kansas in 1541. They encountered the vast and seemingly endless grassland of the Great Plains, meeting various First Nations, including the Wichita people, whom they believed to be rich in gold and silver. However, the expedition did not find any gold or riches, and, like his previous expedition, was ultimately unsuccessful.